is computer geek, tutorials. This is how to debug your power supply unit if broken. This one is currently broken. I know that the part is blown, but beforehand I didn't. It was plugged in. What you're gonna need is a multimeter. Looks like this. Preferably one that can go up to 10 amps at 600 volts. If not less. If it's any less, you're gonna blow it. Then what you're gonna need to do is you're gonna need to follow the traces on this on the circuit or on the board. Be very careful though when you plug it in. The one I myself grounded. This is not literally grounded, but like I'm literally plugged into the wall, ground pin on the wall, in order to prevent myself from being shocked. And so yeah, that's how that is done. Yeah, I'll show you over here. Yeah, I'm literally plugged into this pin on the wall. And when you do that before you plug the power supply unit in. I already know what's broken on here, I've already tested it. One of the things you should not touch, you shouldn't touch anything on here, I should say. Especially not the heat sinks. These heat sinks. Those two. When you touch those with your hand, you will get shocked, as I speak from experience. So what you're going to want to do, you want to set your multimeter on AC. Should be on auto, otherwise you're going to blow it. If you have a less tech one, set it to less high tech. Set the range as I'm doing. It should automatically be on auto though. So what ends up happening is, first you're going to go to the power, where the power goes in, that's the first area where the power touches the board. And it says 123.3 volts, should be 120, but that variation doesn't matter. That's going to happen no matter what. Then you're going to go to the next place where it touches, which would be this resistor right here, back here, and that'd be right here and here.